Decolonizing Africa starts with simple things. Starts with doing away with apartheid colonial symbols and colonial way of doing things. It must, we must, and even if it's not our generation, generations to come, we must have a language that unites Africans, like Swahili. If Swahili can be developed and it become a continental language, and then we do away with speaking to each other in English, because that's what colonizers did, divided us, made sure that we don't have a common language to communicate amongst ourselves, and then we use their language to communicate so that they can hear everything we say. So we need to do away with that. If we want Africa, which will be an equal competitor with the West and America. So it is through small things that we'll realize a total freedom of Africa, not only a South Africa. I was very worried with those judges in Zimbabwe. Even our judges here, they wear those green things. I don't know what do these things represent. What is that? What symbol is that? Does it mean when you're wearing this thing, you can only think when you're wearing a wig that looks like the hair of white people? You're actually wearing white brains. The reason you think properly is that wig, according to colonialism. And then revolutionaries like ZANU-PF allows that to continue in Zimbabwe. They allow that to continue in Kenya. Well, Kenya, of course, is something different. I don't think there is a total independence there. America has got a huge interest in that affair, in that arrangement of Kenya. But everywhere else in the continent, we need to start doing away with those things. And pulling out of Commonwealth is one of the things we need to do to realize a complete sovereignty for South Africa. We must not be scared to say that. We must be hated. It might not happen now, but that is what we're envisaging for the future of South Africa. It might not be realized in our lifetime, but those who are coming after us should know what we stood for. We were anti-colonial, anti-imperialist, and therefore, anything that represented imperialism and colonialism, we reject. In the same way we reject Trump, in the same way we reject Theresa May, we reject everything that represented. When we said roads must fall, we meant exactly that, that we need to do away with symbols that represent colonialism. As we speak now, the EFF doesn't participate in the Commonwealth Parliament Forum. We don't. The EFF refuses to participate in multinational organizations that have got close links and relations with imperialism. We refuse. We don't. We don't do that. And our going to London, talking to business people in London, talking to business people in America, everywhere else, it's not talking to imperialism. It's talking to individual potential investors. The same thing we can do in Nigeria. The same thing we can do in Kenya. We need a borderless continent. We need a continent with one currency. We need a continent with one parliament, which has got teeth and it will bite and hold the executives in countries accountable. And ultimately, we need one African president. We need United States of Africa. We supported and we continue to support those ideals of brother leader Gaddafi. We're following in the footsteps of those leaders. We are not saying they were perfect, some of them, but they are a lot of teachings that come from our leaders in the continent which we can follow because we think they will unite us. This thing was a one thing called Africa. This was one thing. It was divided by colonizers. These borders are artificial borders imposed on us by colonizers. Why do you want to behave like you are owning colonizers' properties? These borders are colonizers' properties, they are not ours. Let us go back to African unity. We want one voice, one Africa. We must stop doing away with African hate, which was instilled in us by the colonizers. When you say, hey, there are too many Zimbabweans here, there are too many Nigerians here, hey, you are doing the work of the devil, which is to divide Africans. Be angry with Nigerians and South Africans for doing crimes, Zimbabweans, the same way you are with South Africans who commit crimes. They must be treated the same. It must not be because it's a Nigerian, it's a more crime. If a Nigerian kills a person, that killing is twice. As if the murder by South African is lesser than a Nigerian murder. It's wrong. Crime is crime. Let's deal with it as crime. When it is a white person in South Africa, undocumented, he's called an investor. Not only a white person, including Indians and Chinese. These Guptas didn't have proper papers yet. These Guptas didn't have proper papers. No one dared called them Kwerekweres. No one. But if it was my African brothers, we're going to be called Kwerekweres because they don't have papers. Self-hate. It must come to an end. If it means making the EFF lose votes for that, let it lose votes. Lose votes on principle. Not on political expediency of wanting to appeal. This country belongs to Africans in the same way Nigeria belongs to South Africans.